Hi, I'm Stacey Portugal, board certified life coach specializing in weight loss and creator of My Custom Keto, a simple and easy to follow approach that will help you identify your optimal carb intake so you'll lose weight, tame temptation, and balance your hormones. Today, we are making a poultry or meat sausage with some roasted veggies. This is a really easy recipe. It's low carb and it is delicious. So let's get started. Okay, folks, step one, purchase the sausage of your choosing. Of course, I recommend either turkey or chicken or meat or pork is fine. But I would, of course, make sure that it is more of the homemade variety or just has as few fillers as possible. Fat for a low-carb diet, as you know, is just fine. But we want to make sure this sausage is low in carbs. It should have a moderate amount of protein and a generous amount of fat. So choose the sausage of your choosing, and as you can see, I simply created a bunch of vegetables that I love. I couldn't give you the exact amount, but what I did was I used about a pint of just sliced mushrooms. I took just a couple of peppers, cut them up. These were the mini peppers. And then for the broccoli, I just bought a bag of already cut organic broccoli. And certainly, depending on the size of, you know, the cooking utensil that you're using, I was using a Pyrex, so I just bought enough to fill a Pyrex. All right, so go ahead, brown your sausage. It should be able to cook in its own fat, but depending on your fat goals, I want you to feel free to add an additional tablespoon of olive oil. And then go ahead, brown the sausage until it's nice and brown, but not fully cooked. Okay, once the sausage is cooked and your veggies are in your Pyrex, go ahead and cut the sausage. What I did was I cut it up into 6 pieces, each sausage, so that when I was serving myself, I knew that 1 piece of sausage were 6 pieces. So you can do it any way you want, but it's a little bit easier to serve yourself that way and keep track of the amount that you're eating. I added an additional 2 tablespoons of olive oil to the entire Pyrex mixture. This helps coat the vegetables for roasting. And I added the sort of the fat, the rendering from the sauteing of the sausage. I also added just a dash of Himalayan salt, and you may also use some Italian seasonings if you choose. I cooked this mixture. As you can see, some of the sausage is, you know, not fully cooked, which is exactly what you want. And all you really need is about 30 minutes on, I do convection bake, which is 375. If you're at a 350, I would do about 30 to 45 minutes tops, but go ahead and check it to be sure. Okay, here is where I did something a little different, and I do this pretty often to serve myself so that I know exactly what I'm eating. What I did was I took my serving, which last night was just 1 sausage, so it was 6 small pieces with as many vegetables really essentially as I wanted. It was about, you know, 1 cup, maybe 1.5 cups. And then I topped it with a 1/2 cup of marinara sauce and 1/4 cup of shredded cheese. And this way, I knew exactly what I was eating. And actually, at the end of this video, I'm going to give you the full recipe and nutritional information. It was delicious, as you can see, and I have plenty of leftovers to use during the week. Here is the recipe in its entirety. It serves five, and it's making the assumption that there are five sausages in the package that you buy. And it is per serving. So enjoy. Remember, you can always play around, add a little bit more fat to your dish if you need it, or even a little less marinara sauce. Okay, folks, hope you enjoy this. Feel free to share with friends, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.